Okay, good afternoon class. Now today we start the difference between traditional programming and the machine learning programming actually. So how we can solve the problem using the machine learning? Before it that, you must understand the working of traditional programming. So what do you mean by the traditional programming? The traditional programming are the programs that we are used for performing a task or the process. Okay, so normal programming we are used in a traditional programming are Java. C++, as it is very popular programming language among the science and engineering students, and the C language. So these are the few programming languages. They are very popular to write a program in computer. So you can use any one of these programming language, for example Java, C++ or C, write a code and send it to the central processing unit called as a CPU. This CPU has some inbuilt compiler, compile this programming and convert it into the binary language that is a 0 and 1. Okay, so CPU sended this program to the compiler, okay, and that compiler may be a C++ compiler or C++ compiler or the Java compiler. Okay, so these are the compilers, they are used to convert the high level language into the low level language, that is 0 and 1, and if they want, collect the data from the database, and that database normally we can call as a DBMS. Okay, so these are the programming languages, Java, C++ and C, and the DBMS, we are combining this and we are providing the output as the screen. So this is your screen, and on this screen you will get the output. Okay, so this is a normal execution of traditional program. Take one example, and through this example let us understand how this traditional programming is work. So let us consider, I want to do the very simple program addition of a two numbers. So what I am doing, I am taking the two variables A and B and storing the addition into the third variable, that is a C. And for that I have to write my program, let us consider in a C++ programming language. Okay. So using this C++ programming language, I am making the addition of two numbers and storing this two numbers into the C. So this C program we are sending to the compiler or CPU, that some CPU use the C++ compiler and convert this value into the machine learning language. Okay, that is high level programming to low level programming language. Meanwhile, let us consider we have the some data in database and store the data like a 10, 20, 30, 40 and so on. Okay. So this is the data is available in our database. Okay, that is a 10, 20, 30 and 40. Okay, and we are compiling this program, C is equal to A plus B. So as it requires the two variables, okay, A and the B, so compiler has select the two number randomly. So let us consider it compiler select the number 1 and the 2. So that is the 10 and the 20. So what will be the output here? Correctly. So the output here will be the 30. Why? Because here A is now a 20 and B is now a 10 and the B is by the 20. So 10 plus 20 is equal to 30. Okay, and this 30 will be displayed on your screen, that is your output. So this is a simple traditional programming where the programmer has to write down the program using the any programming language. Okay, and it take a data from the database that is available in the database and combine it using the CPU, using the this circuit of compiler, and display it on the screen. So this is called as a traditional programming. I hope you understand the traditional programming part. Now, in opposite to the machine learning, what happened in a machine learning approach? In machine learning approach, first you have to give the what is your expected output, what is your expectation. So here I am giving my expectation that I want a output like a 30. Okay, so I am giving the my expected output. I am not saying that how we can perform this 30 and all the other things. I just mention to my computer that hey, I want a output is equal to 30. So you are sending this your output expectation or prediction to the computer, and normally it contains the GPU, that is a graphical processing unit. Okay, so here we are using the CPU while we are using here the GPU, graphical processing. Okay, so you are sending your expected output, that is a 30 you want, and again it has the data, and this data set contains 10, 20, 30 and the 40. Again it has its own data set, okay, and it contains the values like 10, 20, 30 and 40. And your GPU is called the various machine learning algorithms that inbuilt libraries are there, or deep learning libraries, or the machine learning libraries. Now let us consider we are concentrating on the machine learning only. So GPU called the machine learning libraries, and ask them, hey, there is a requirement that they want a output like a 30. So what will I can do? Okay, so the machine learning algorithm has n number of libraries. So he make a one checking. Okay, here. Okay, and they find out that if you are performing 10 plus 20, you will get the output 30. So this is one of the answer. So you can use the operators plus here. Either you can do one thing, you can directly display the output 30, because 30 is already available in our data set. So why we are making the addition, as that 30 is already available. So as it is, you can show it to the out as output here. So 30 is there. So another option is that you can do one thing, 40 minus 10. Okay, so you can also do this, 40 minus 10. So when you do the 40 minus 10, obviously you will get the 30. So these are the options you have available in your machine learning algorithm, that either you can go with the addition, either you can go with your subtraction, or either you can use the 30 as it is. Okay, so here we are just providing the what is your expected output and the data. Okay, this data is most important, because without the data, that's why in the last lecture I told you, because of the data, the machine learning, the deep learning, the AI nowadays are the buzzword, or they are more important nowadays. Okay, so the reason behind that, these are the data is available. So 10, 20, 30, these are the data. So n number of data is nowadays available, and because of the availability of data, this machine learning, this deep learning nowadays are very popular. Okay, so in this our example, so you either you can take addition of these two numbers 10 plus 20, or you can directly display the number that is a 30, or what you can do, you can make a subtraction 40 minus 10. So when you do that 40 minus 10, you can also get the output 30. So there are the n number of options you are available, and you have to select anyone, and then you can get the output. Okay, so this is the approach of machine learning we are used. Here we don't want to write a program from the scratch. Okay, the libraries are available. You have to just call that libraries, and libraries have performed their own task. Okay, so this is a basic difference between the traditional programming and in the machine learning. So in the traditional programming, you have to write down your own code from the scratch, from the first line to the 100 or the 1000 line. Okay, using any programming language like Java, C++ or C. While in a machine learning, you have to use only the machine learning approach. So that machine learning approach, you can say that there are the inbuilt applications, inbuilt algorithms are available. Okay, and just you have to call them libraries, and using the graphical process unit, it handles the
huge amount of data at a time, and we can get the expected output. So here you are just provide your expected output, what output you want, and here you are blankly coding the data, coding the code, okay, and taking the data, and you are getting the output. So either output is your unexpected, you don't know what will be the output, okay. But here you know what is your output, and then you are providing this data to the machine model, okay, machine learning model. The machine learning model take data from the data set, and then it will make some changes internally, and it will give the output as it is you like. Okay, so this is called as a machine learning versus traditional program. So I hope you understand the machine learning and the difference between the machine learning and the traditional program. Okay, is it okay, class? I hope you understand. Okay.